y'all, it's your girl The Key Is Me, and I am back again with another video. Y'all, let me find out that I no longer have to sit for 8 hours to get my hair braided. Y'all can't tell me this don't look like I just went to the salon and got my hair braided. I am shook. Okay, shook that this is a braided wig and it looks as natural as it does. Okay, so just stated, this is a braided wig. This wig is from Neat and Sleek. Reach out to me for me to review one of their braided wigs, and I'm absolutely in love with this wig. As you can see, I'm going to be popping in some inserts in the screen. So the hair came packaged in there. There's this cute gold satin bag that has their logo on it as well. Inside of the package, they did include some gold clips to go ahead and put on your braids. If you would like to jazz your braids up and give them an extra look, you can definitely do that with this. This wig right now on their website is $250. It is a full lace wig. They do have different color. They have a natural black color, they have an off-black color, as well as a ombre color. I'll try to pop it in the screen so that you can see it. It's absolutely gorgeous. See, the hair does come equipped with your standard combs as well as an elastic band. I absolutely love the elastic band that she decided to choose for her wigs because of the simple fact that it has it kind of reminds me of a bra strap. You know how like we have the three different rows that we can choose from to actually clip the actual piece on? It has that. So if you want to make it tighter, you can make it tighter. If you want to make it a little looser, you can do that as well. On top of it, her already putting an elastic band inside of her wigs. Of course, the cap does come with the adjustable bands in the back as well. Now, I do believe that if you wanted to put this up into a ponytail, you can definitely do that because it does have the combs in the back. As you can see, it is constructed with the lace in the back. To be honest, I mean, the whole wig is full lace. So if you wanted to put it up into a ponytail, you definitely can get away with that because it's a full lace wig. Like most wigs, when you get wigs done, it's a cap, it's just like a regular cap in the back, but this actually mimics scalp in the back. As you can see, still the color of the entire wig to make it seem like you actually have full-fledged braids braided to your scalp. Like you can see, taking it out of the pack, the knots were already bleached. That's a plus. I didn't have to tint the lace. That's an extra plus. The lace literally looks transparent on my skin. Now, it doesn't say it's transparent, but I'm just gonna add this in there that to me it looks transparent on my skin. As you can see with the clips of me popping it in, it just blended so flawlessly. Like, I really didn't have to do too much to this wig at all. I just pretty much put it on my head. Now, I can warn you that if you do want to wear this style up into a ponytail, you will have to at least glue the side tabs down. As you can see, the tabs will kind of fly up because it's the fact that if you're pulling your actual braids up into a ponytail, the flaps are not going to stay down. That's pretty much a given. I did go ahead and add a little bit of Got to Be Glue styling gel. I pop in the screen the one that I use. I just used a little bit of that just to put one side down because I know I wanted to wear my hair pushed to this side. So this side is, the left side of my head is covered, so I just did the right side just a little bit, and then I went ahead and cut the baby hairs. Now with the baby hairs, they do come really long. I'm not a fan of baby hairs, to be honest with you. I like them to be very minimal, so I did go ahead with the tweezers just to tweeze out some of them. To me, I probably should have done this step before I put the wig on my head, because once it was already on my head, it was a little hard for me to actually tweeze some of the hair. So I just went ahead and I just gelled the edges down, and because I gelled the edges down, it kind of just stuck to my forehead. So you don't even really have to glue this wig down. It's secure because of the fact that I went ahead and I gelled my edges down with the Got to Be Glue styling gel. That's it. I didn't have to glue this thing down. To be honest with you, I don't have my combs in, and it's secure. I'm pulling on it. Now, I usually don't like to use the combs if I don't have to, and I don't know if I stated, but this wig is in the cap size medium. Now, I do have a large head, so I would definitely suggest if you have a large head like myself, I think I range from a 23 inch to a 23 and a half inch. I'm kind of in between both of those, the circumference of my head. I definitely suggest you getting this wig custom. She has an option on the website for you to get a small size cap, a medium size cap, or a custom. I definitely suggest you get a custom, especially when you're making an investment like this for a wig that you want to last a long time. This could definitely last forever, to be honest with you, as long as you're not doing nothing extreme. This wig is definitely gonna last you a while. So I didn't have to add any powder to this. I didn't have to add any extra spray. I didn't have to add any type of color to the lace at all. This is straight out of the pack. The only thing that I use is the Got to Be Glue styling gel. That's it. Not that's it. That's it. Okay, that's it. This is a great investment and it is a great quality wig. As you can see, the braids are very neatly braided. They're very tight, they're very form fitting. They come all the way, they're braided literally all the way down to the ends. And it's just, they're so light. The only thing that I don't like about it is that it does have a funny smell to it. And it could just be the actual packaging. Because you know, when something's being shipped and it's being in the pack, you know, it could be that, or it could just be the actual hair. So you could definitely wash this wig. I wouldn't physically go in and wash it. What I would do is I would put it in a bucket full of warm water and a whole bunch of conditioner, mix the conditioner up in it, and just let the wig soak in it. That's all you have to do. You don't physically have to go in and actually wash it like hair. You just put it in some conditioner, some warm water, and let it soak, and then rinse it out with warm water or cold water, and then you'll be good to go. Now, I do believe that over time, with your edges, of course, they're gonna get some type of product buildup. I would just go in with a little bit of shampoo and just pretty much rub them on the edges, because this hair is left out. You don't have to rub them on the braids because this is braided. You would just rub it on the edges and then rinse it out and then dip them in the conditioner water and then be on about your day. Like, you don't really have to do too much. Probably just throw it up on a mannequin head, lay it outside if you have a porch, and just let it dry. Size, but I do not have this glued down. So if you were to go like this, you would definitely see that I don't have it glued down. But I mean, even then, look how flawlessly, when I put it down, look how it just blends into my skin. I don't have to really do too much to it. I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love. And for $259, like, this is such a great investment. I just recently got my hair braided. It took her about 7.5 hours to braid my hair. I have really thick hair and I'm natural. So it took her about seven and a half hours to do my hair. Guess how long I kept those braids in? 2 weeks. And it's not because I wanted to take them out, because to be honest, they still look good. They still look uniform. It was because my braids around my edges were coming out. And after 2 weeks, after your braids are falling out, if you go back to the stylist, of course, they're going to charge you an extra fee to redo the front part of your head. So to me, it's just like, because I am the way that I am when it comes to hair, I always have to make sure I'm making a good investment right now. Like, I have so much that I have going on, trying to save. I want to buy a house soon. I could be possibly, you know, moving. Like, there's just so much, trying to pay student loans. There's just so much that I'm doing right now, to the point where I just have to be very strategic about where I spend all of my money. And I know me, as y'all can see, I love getting my nails done. I love keeping my hair done. Love having my lashes. Like, I'm just that type of girl. Love wearing my makeup. I love looking good. So to me, it's just like, I have to cut corners. So when I find stuff like this is everything to me. Like, I'm gonna put everybody that I know on. I literally just called one of my best friends and was like, sis, look at this. And she like, girl, I know you didn't get your hair done. Is that a wig? Yes, it is a wig. So I definitely suggest that y'all click the description box down below. Like I said, it will be an investment, but it's an investment that is going to last you, I know for a fact, over a year. So definitely check them out. I'm gonna put all of their information down in the description box down below. Y'all let me know what y'all think. I'm gonna put all of their information down in the description box below. Thank you so much for tuning into this video. If you could please like, comment, subscribe, and share. And I look forward to seeing you in my next video.